But if I had a way of buying a couple hundred thousand single-family homes and had a way of managing, the management is enormous. It was really a problem because they're one by one. They're not like apartment houses. So, but I would load up on them, and I would take mortgages out at very, very low rates. But if anybody is thinking about buying homes, 5 years ago they couldn't buy them fast enough because they thought they were going to go up, and now they don't buy them because they think they're going to go down, and interest rates are far lower. It's a way, in effect, to short the dollar because you can take a 30-year mortgage, and if it turns out your interest rate's too high next week, you refinance lower, and if it turns out it's too low, the other guy's stuck with it for 30 years. So it's a very attractive asset class now.
If you are a young individual investor at home and you have your choice between buying your first home or investing in stocks, where would you tell someone is the better bet?
If I thought I was going to live, if I knew where I was going to want to live the next 5 or 10 years, I would buy a home and I'd finance it with a 30-year mortgage. And it's a terrific deal. And if I was an investor that was a handy type, which I'm not, and I could buy a couple of them at distressed prices and find renters, I think that's, and again, take a 30-year mortgage. It's a leveraged way of owning a very cheap asset now. And no, I think that's probably as attractive an investment as you can make.